Hey, good evening, everybody. How are we all doing? I'm following Gussie Moose. Actually, that was really great. That was awesome. That was loud. The whole book story reading thing that she's been doing is really awesome. Although I'll honestly admit, I'm a little behind in my reading, so I'm not necessarily the one who's up to date with all that, so I have to do a little more reading. I've been spending too much time gaming, actually, and not enough time actually reading the books. So I gotta find some time to do that. But so how's everybody doing tonight? For those of you who don't know me, I am Evil Twin, and this is my usual time slot. I am. Let's see. Well, I do a lot of things in this game. I've been around this game a long time. Most of you know that my main characters are burglars. I have two. I have a 105 on Landreval, and I have a 50 that's part of a 50 level cap group over on Brandywine. I've been wanting to just kind of do some different things and kind of get back to learning some other classes and stuff. And I was playing my hunter. I think that was last week, right? In my show last week. I figured maybe I'd just kind of continue with that. So I have my bald-headed, well-armored hobbit that is my hunter, and it's level 60. Last week I spent some time. I got out of I had just gotten out of Moria, so I was just starting to do all of the things at the exit of Moria that leads down into Lothlorien, and I think I finished most of that. So I think what I'm going to probably do is head back down there to talk to Haldir, and then we'll go from there. We'll kind of pick up some quests and maybe start to work some things around the outsides of Lothlorien, and see where we go from there. Hey, Gussie, how are you? Good to see you. Okay, day up until the past couple of hours. Really, Zeus? What's up, man? Shaved head hobbit. Yes, exactly. Don't ask me why I did that. I mean, there are so many hairstyles and stuff that you can choose from. But for some reason, when I was just going through them on this character, I'm like, you don't ever usually see a bareheaded hobbit, right? It's just like, it just doesn't happen. And what's nice is you can make out the fact that they have some pointy ears, which most people probably don't really realize either, right? Because you don't see their ears as easily. So that's kind of it's kind of what I got in mind for tonight. So what I got to figure out is, now see, I don't play a hunter very, very often. Hey, Strider, how are you, man? Good to see you. I don't play a hunter very often, so I'm not terribly used to all of the skills. When I hadn't played this character for quite a bit of time, actually. And if you look at my skill tree, I did choose to go blue line. That seems to be what the cool kids are doing these days. So I'm running blue line hunter. Let's see, what do I got for? I do have a levels. I have a level 60. I have a level 60 third age bow and a level 60 second age spear. But that seems to be the majority of my stuff. So at least I have current legendary items that I can work on and level up. I gotta remember, like, traveling skills. I gotta see where I can go from here. So I'm guessing 21st Hall is probably the best place to go, and then I can kind of get myself out from there. But I have a ton of things that I still don't remember how to do with my hunter very much. So maybe I'll be asking for some help tonight while we're going on. Yes, pew pew. You run red line with blue as your secondary. Okay. Red line for the win. Yeah, I see you guys are all going to argue about that. I don't know. I mean, there's been a lot of talk lately and about blue line versus red line, blue line hunters and all that. And for anybody who's watched me recently with my level 50 capped burglar over on Brandywine. I had made the decision to go blue line there, and of course burglar is very different, but I made the decision to go blue line with my burglar because I had never done blue line before. So now, my hunter is totally different really because I haven't played it for so long. my skill trees, I had nothing. I basically, it was like, okay, I have all these points to spend because everything got reset, right? So I guess, you know, like I said, all the current buzz is about Blue Line for the Hunter. So that's kind of what I chose to do. Let me see. I'm going to get some other stuff going here. All right. I am in live stream for those of you who are in my Discord, so I can pull you in if folks want to talk. All right. So let's see. We're going to head to First Hall. Oh, did I hit Anazar Mekum? I did. Oh, sweet. I got dinner. I've been given quesadillas that have been made for dinner. Unfortunately, this stream tends to run like right around the time that the family runs gets home and my wife's making dinner and stuff. So
these halls will be great.
All right,
once
so let's
more.
Try that again. First hall, let's go there. I will try to not be obnoxiously eating on dinner, our dinner on stream. But I may actually be eating a little bit, so my apologies for that. I don't usually try to eat on stream, but I'm really hungry today. Any guesses for your presence, both? I do have new presents for today. Maybe we'll do one later. We'll see how that goes. All right, First Hall. So, speak with Haldir at his Talon. As you can see, I still have books to do. You know, I haven't finished that one yet. Talk to Narmaleth at Delisad. See, I'm almost tempted to want to go finish up book 15 on this tune. There's kind of a lot of back and forth, but I don't know. You guys tell me, do you want to see some Lothlorien or you want to see volume 1 book 15? Let me know what you guys want to see me do tonight, because I can do either. Actually, what do I have for Hunter too? I've got, I still have level 50 Hunter quests to do. See, that just goes to show you how little I have done on this tune. Zeus, I didn't ask about presents yet, man. Are you trying to get him in early so you can leave or what? Random stuff today, yeah. So what else do I have? I have a lot of group stuff in Moria. I have...
I think you should totally do Lothlorien, because...
Really? You think I should? And hi, Gessy Moods.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. The dogs are chilling out right now, so I'm not going to go downstairs.
You got some chill dogs, huh?
So, yeah.
Okay.
I'm just going to sit up here and chill out until they come to get me and tell me that they go outside.
You see this? I'm a bad hunter. I haven't even done my level 50 hunter quests yet. But the thing is, like, they're not... You know well, what? Actually, so you know what? They would get... If I finished those, that would get me the points, you know, for the trait points, right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So I'm going to have to work on that if I'm going to mess around with my hunter some more.
You should work on that.
I should work on that. Yeah. All right. Then we will head down to Lothlorien then.
Well, don't go there just because I... Because
Gussie said to.
Oh, my God.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to Lothlorien because Gussie told me to.
Wow. Now, if everybody in my life just felt that way, I'd get a lot accomplished. Mom said so. Okay, I'll go. Oh, the wife said so. Okay, let's go.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. That's how it goes. It's like, yes, dear. Right?
Mm-hmm. And then they roll their eyes in the back of their
head.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So I see you got dinner.
I did. I had dinner like brought into me. I have chicken quesadillas. So, sorry, I'm gonna eat a little bit because I'm hungry.
Hey, everybody in chat.
But I'll try to not talk with my mouth full, which is gonna be hard.
Chicken quesadilla sounds. Is it like a Taco Bell quesadilla?
No. My wife made them from scratch.
Oh.
She uses a I don't know. I'm trying to think of what the sauce, the seasoning is for the. It's like one of the McCormick seasonings or something like that, for the chicken.
Well, there's so fajita and the taco seasoning.
So that's it. It's the fajita seasoning. Yeah, damn it! Look at that. Look at that. Gussie Moose is like right on point with the food, man. That's awesome.
I'm telling you, man. I know my cooking.
That's great. No, yeah, that's what it is. She basically cooks up the chicken in a fajita mix to give it some seasoning, and then you know you throw them in the tortillas or mm-hmm. and you know cheese and stuff. So yeah, that. Good. And I just made everybody in the chat like really hungry or something. I don't know. We'll see.
The McCormick seasonings have saved my butt so many times on things. Oh my gosh.
Well, they make for great on streaming meals because I guess they're easy to make and eat. So yeah, and the fact that my stream happens to run at 6, it's for official Lotro, it's I'm Thursday night is kind of like we call it grab and growl, you know, kind of night. So that's kind of what Thursday nights are around here because I'm streaming, it's doing something formal for dinner that usually doesn't work very well, so
I had to refresh the Twitch page just now.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that. It's because I am so awesome, it just couldn't handle me.
Lord, here we go.
So, for those of you, I didn't have it last week, so for those of you who haven't caught my streams on my channel all week, you'll notice I don't have any background behind me. I don't have any 3D printer anymore. I don't have, I got rid of all that. Yes. Well, all the junk that is like, on my workbench behind me, kind of thing.
Oh, you mean, oh yeah. I'm enjoying the green screen.
I like it. I think it kind of cleans up the picture a little bit. Yeah. And the other thing too is what I think I've noticed is I think it's actually helped the lighting that I have, the screen behind me, like the light doesn't just get lost in the depth of my room, so the lighting is a little better, I think. But I didn't actually have to change my lighting to suit the green screen. Did you have to do that for yours?
Yeah. Well, no, because my set came with two lights.
Okay.
And so I still, like, my room, I mean, most everybody knows, my room is, like, in shambles at the moment. So hopefully
this mine's always in a shambles.
I can continue to get these boxes and these things out of my room so that I have, like, the screen is, like, almost back up against me. So hopefully I can get it pushed back and kind of get the two lights put up this weekend. And
Right.
I mean, it's doing okay with what I have for right now, but I know I can improve it just a little bit.
So. Oh, so yeah. Zeus, that's what you got in your presences today? Okay. I didn't understand what you were saying. He got run speed boosts craft XP. So that's cool.
I'm going to save my boxes for Monday. I didn't get a chance. I was so like in the book club thing was so amazing today. I totally forgot to do my presences. So I'll just hold off and I'll open them up today.
Okay. See, now this is okay. So I made it to Talon Haldir, right? So, and I'm not going to do a lot of quest reading just because most people have probably been through most of this anyway, right?
I think you should read through every single bit of it. Oh,
yeah, I know.
Don't you die, Colin? Check up, Getsy.
Welcome to Lothlorien, Hunter. No, sorry. I'm not feeling it tonight. I just want to chat, and I just want to kind of chill, and, because I've been playing that other game all week, so I'm kind of a little out of sorts with my Lotro right now.
I hear you.
So, That's been fun, though. That's been a lot of fun. So okay, so now here's my worry. See, I didn't finish all of the books inside of Moria.
Oh.
Even though I've left Moria, I'm still on book 4, chapter 7.
Oh yeah, you know what? I didn't on my Hunter. I haven't. Nimwin hasn't finished her Moria books either, and I didn't have any problems.
Yeah, that's the thing. I wasn't. I could go back and do them. What's
yeah,
that?
I think you could. I could be wrong, but I think book 3. Don't we pick up book 3 like right at the tail end of Moria, or like right at the beginning of Lothlorien or something? Like
no, I book 9 is the beginning of Lothlorien.
Oh, okay.
And I'm still on book 4. So, yeah, there's a whole all the stuff that happens inside of Moria, I still have all of that to do. For gotcha. The epic line. So, but yeah, we'll work on it.
I didn't finish.
So bring Celeborn's letter to Rolfr.
Oh, okay.
And
the Golden Host is at last ready to cross.
Talk to Braglin at Imlad Laleith. Where the frick is that? I forget. Isn't that way? Is that back way up north? Let's see.
I don't know.
That's way. Okay, so that's way over there, almost down by Great River.
Lorien.
The Goodwill of the Gallagher.
Where are you going to?
Imlad Laleith, which is down near the vineyards, over near the Anduin. So that's one of them. And then bring Celeborn's letter to Rolfr. He is at the Chamber of Crossroads inside of Moria. So that's the thing. I'm going to wind up with a lot of these quests that like I'm going to have to do a lot of running around and back and forth.
Well, that's our Lothlorien's. That's not the book quest, though, right? I mean, that's just.
Oh wait, there's more.
Well, it
one is the book quest.
Letter, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
We have need of your
that's
services.
An important quest.
Oh yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. That gets a lot of things started there. So.
Yeah.
All right. Let's see. Collect orc weapons. And these are the dailies,
the
right? These turn into dailies
services.
That you have to do to get reputation with the Galadrim.
I think so. There's quite a few
orcs.
Of them. I enjoyed doing.
Elder James is like, read it all.
7's Lothlorien, 9 is Mirkwood. Oh, okay. Yeah, I thought it was like somewhere in that.
Zeus said, remember to attack the moose. They give
Don't
you rep.
Kill the moose. I'll regret it.
I risk earning the wrath of Gussie Moose.
Not only that, but you'll lose your rep.
7 is Mirkwood, or 7 is Lothlorien, and
yeah.
9 is Mirkwood?
It's Mirkwood, yeah.
Oh, so book 9 is Mirkwood, so we don't even really want to do that yet. Actually, I can't. And that's what I was curious about. I can't even get there yet, because that's all the way on the other side of Lothlorien. So, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to cancel that and just leave it up in the tree for now.
That's a good idea. As long as you know, as long as you can remember where to go and pick it up.
It won't let me cancel it.
Oh.
Why can't I cancel the quest? Bug.
Well, I had that problem the other day with the.
That's very odd.
The
Normally,
Yule Festival quest kept popping up even though it was already over. I couldn't get it to.
I can't. I can't get it to cancel that quest. That's really odd. I've never seen that before. Yeah, won't let me cancel it. That's very strange. All right, well, I guess I'll just keep it and have to track it some other way.
Yeah, just
later.
Like take.
Yeah,
it right
yeah,
off
just take it off the room. List. That's all. Heading into Mirkwood now after seeing Gussie there for bingo.
Really not.
I'm really not interested.
Oh my gosh, Bingo Boffin was hideous on Tuesday.
Like, oh really? Why?
Like,
what happened?
God, please get me out. I just the feeling of being over there just made me very ill-mannered and ill-tempered, and I was just not a happy person. Very evil.
Ooh, my kind of story.
Like, well, they take you to go through near Dol Guldur, and so it was like I got into Dol Guldur by mistake. I was supposed to go in there, but just briefly. But I got in there, I got lost in there. I was like frustrated, like I was that feeling.
Right.
Like I was talking about earlier, I was just like, you know, I give bravos to the devs because when they can make you feel that way in a game, you know, Dol Guldur, Angmar, any of these evil quote unquote
right,
places.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Like when they can make you feel that way while you're just in the game playing,
yeah,
then you know that they've done their job.
Oh, like, sure.
They totally nailed it. And Dol Guldur just absolutely made me like, oh, I didn't even stick around. I was just like, you know what? I'm taking a mithril coin and I'm getting out of here. I'm done with this place. Get me back. Let's get back to Lothlorien and head up to the river.
Yeah.
Invoke such, you know,
just, animosity.
I was just frustrated and like, I was pissed. Actually, I just like I got pissed in there. Not gonna lie, I was just really frustrated.
Sure, sure.
So they do a very good job of bringing out whatever feelings that each area. Like when I'm in Lothlorien, everything is beautiful and peaceful, and I'm happy, and you know, it's so relaxing and stuff, and it's just like, you know, each area invokes a certain feeling, and that's exactly what they're going for. So
what's that Sheller Moss gonna get a hard time in Mordor then?
Moose.
Oh, okay. You said Moss.
Oh,
I was like,
Sheller, I'm sure I'm not gonna be a happy person when Mordor hit. I'm sure.
All that evil going on.
Yeah. I'm sure I will not be happy, but we'll make do.
There's supposed to be more orcs up here? Yes, there is. I gotta kill the orcs. There's a warg.
Thanks a lot.
What?
Oh, my stomach's growling now, thank you.
Oh, why? Because I'm all like about food?
Yep.
Oh God, I'm so OP.
I made some for lunch today. I made jasmine rice, and I cooked it in chicken broth.
Ooh.
And so I have some jasmine rice, and then I made some salmon fillets, and I did a kind of an orange ginger teriyaki sauce. It's got a little bit of pineapple in it too, but just a little bit of a sauce for the fish, and some asparagus.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Evil Twin Cooking Hour.
Well, I mean, Lotro and food. I mean,
yeah, well, yeah, there's that's, and I am a hobbit after all, you know, for tonight. So there's that.
But I don't want to go downstairs, sleeping right
now. Zeus says. There's this. That's the salted butter in Mordor.
Oh my god!
Man, these orcs seem to be sort of spread out, few and far between. I remember doing a lot of this way back. It's been so long since I've done any of this area. It's been a really long time. So I'm, you know, getting used to any of it. again. Mm-hmm. It's going to take a little time. Ugh, I'm so overpowered.
Isn't Hunters fabulous?
Yeah, if you like being uber everything.
Well, yeah, of course we like being uber everything.
I don't know. It's never been my first choice of class. You know, being a ranged class, I'm more for melee classes. You know, it's like, hey,
I used to be more melee, like, but as I've aged, I have had a harder time, especially controlling mouse and keyboard movements and whatnot.
Okay.
With my hands being melee, whereas, you know, melee, like, especially if I was a tank or, you know, the typical warrior or whatever you want to call it, like, I have a harder time moving my mouse around and getting, you know, behind the mobs or in front of the ball, you know, sure. Depending on what it's like, whereas with a ranged class, I have a little bit of an easier time just kind of hanging back.
Okay.
And DPSing from far type of thing. I guess that's why I've done it. I mean, I used to tank all the time in games and all that stuff. 10 years ago, I used to be one hell of a tank, but I just can't do it anymore. I just can't keep up.
Right, right.
With the speed that games has taken, you know, in terms of... I just pew-pew from a distance.
That's pretty much all I'm doing at this point. It's all about the pew-pew.
Pew-pew-pew-pew! Well, apparently this character that I'm on Landerval has never done her skirmish quest stuff.
Oh, what did I just do? I clicked on something. Beneath notice? Oh, that's just threat reduction.
Does he know skirm terms? Oh, Zeus, I used to actually, in that other game that will remain unnamed, I used to, like, back in the day, I used to PvP and stuff on it quite a bit, but I just can't.
Didn't think you were a cold-blooded killer. Yeah, because that's Gussie. She's just a cold-blooded killer.
I know, right? Don't let the looks fool you, buddy. Heartless and ruthless.
And you all thought that, like, butter wouldn't melt in her mouth.
Yep. Tell you what.
Oh, nice. Hello. I'm getting hit here.
All right, let's see. Cold spell. Same anger Gussie feels at Dolguldor is what I felt when you were going through the Theodred dies battle. Oh my god, cold spell. I cried. Don't even get me started on that. Like, I have such a like, my love of, like, the love of Middle Earth to me is all things Rohirrim.
Okay.
So once I got into the river and started heading out towards the Rohan, everything was just like, I was in love with everything. I bet, oh my god, when I had to deal with Theodred, I was just like weeping and sobbing on the, I was just, oh,
I'm telling
god,
your rangers on you.
Blubbering mess. Oh, that's fine, they understand. They know Gussie always comes to them. I mean, he was the future king.
Uh-huh.
Rohan. Poor Sam. All right. Got myself a proper hunter outfit at the skirmish camp so that I can put this on her for my next traipsing through Middle Earth event. Huh? The Christmas dress thing just wasn't cut. I'm already like, when is Spring Festival coming already? Jeez. I need some pinks and some blues and some greens and purples in my life, not dark color.
You need happy colors.
Yes.
Always knew she was evil. I mean, she read Tom's song. That's evil.
I did. I read some of Tom's songs today.
I did hear you doing that, yeah.
That dress was so ugly, guys. He fumbled. He was like, something. Your outfits are hideous.
Jeez. Yeah, at least they're telling it like it is, right?
Oh my god. Hurt. I was crushed.
I've never really gotten into the cosmetic system in the game. I am definitely not a fashion diva by any stretch. All right, let's see. I actually do need to head into Moria because I got to go turn in this other quest for Celeborn's letter. It would seem. It says it's actually a small fellowship quest. Loved this game. It just became too mundane and too easy. I don't know about mundane. There's always a lot of things to do. Yeah, it can be a bit grindy depending on how you're doing with it. But easy, I will tend to agree with that. I think that the difficulty level of the game has gone down over the years. And I think a lot of that is just, you know, to try to appeal to a larger mass of users, that players that you know, they don't necessarily want an easy mode. I mean, there are some that want easy mode. There's no doubt about that. But you know, I think a lot of folks, you know, they want to play it for the story, not for, you know, some epic difficulty and all that kind of stuff, right?
These halls will be great once more.
All right, so let's go right in 21st Hall. I got to go to Chamber of the Crossroads. Oh, just lost power to the house. Is that where you went? Gusty was here, and now she's gone. Uh-oh. I will have to continue without the Gussie for right now. I do have, you know, again, I don't play a hunter very much, so I totally forget that I have ports. And yeah, that's why that's funny. And they don't have a cooldown, do they?
The time has come to drive forth the orcs from our kingdom.
But I do need to take a horse to the Chamber of the Crossroads. I'm sorry. A goat. It was Tom. The stream is no longer a moosing. Oh, God. We did warn people about the puns, though, didn't we? As you can see, I got a bunch of quests in here.
If we are to find Mithril in Khazad-dûm, we will first have to deal with...
This is one of those characters that I actually came through Moria with before they did the rebuild of Moria.
Return soon to his halls.
Oh, okay, so... Help the dwarves regain control of Lumelnar. So, do I have to do those? You should speak with Rolfur and accept his two charges, the conquering of Nal-A-Dûm and the water wheel, where the water wheels are, and Lumelnar, the Hall of Mirrors. Okay. Aren't these three, man? I remember correctly.
Abide here.
Yeah, these are small fellowship three-mans. I'm not going to be doing those. I'll have to hold off on those. Come back for them some other time.
The shadow of Mordor will not long fill the halls of Khazad-dûm.
Let's see. The reason why I fell in love with Lotro was the story-driven plots and not the gameplay. Yeah, and that's kind of the general theme for a lot of folks. You know, the gameplay was different, obviously, many years ago when it first came out. So,
fight for dwarves.
You know, it's different now than it was then. There was a lot more difficulty with things like raids and whatever, but the problem was a lot of people would complain that, you know, hey, I can't get all the great gear because I don't run raids or I don't play enough to be able to, you know, to be in those top tier groups that are able to acquire all of that gear. I remember those complaints very well years ago. And, you know, so the game got easier because people wanted the loot and, you know, the raids kind of went away in favor of a lot of other mechanisms for people to be able to obtain good gear. Oh yeah, Black Mage, you're right. I mean, the gear, the graphics are awesome. I mean, the art style, it is what it is, right? I hear a lot of people nowadays that say, "Oh, the graphics look so bad," you know, and I think they're full of crap, personally. I don't think there's anything wrong with the graphics. It's obviously a specific art style. It's not meant to be cartoonish or embellished, right? It is what it is. You're dealing with humans and hobbits and things like that. You know, those, you know, elves and dwarves. Oh, and Bjornings. We don't want to forget them. But, you know, you're dealing with those as your main classes that you're going to play. And, you know, of course, the game is 10 years old. So, you know, it has the engine that it has. It has the art style that it has. EverQuest had the same issues? Yeah. I never played EverQuest, but okay. I mean, like I said, a lot of people think, well, not a lot. I hear complaints that people say that, you know, they should update the character models. They need to update the graphics in this game because it's so old. But honestly, I've always played, you know, with high-end graphics cards, with all of the eye candy turned on and turned up, and, you know, so, and with the high-resolution textures, that's the other thing. So, if you're watching somebody else play and or stream the game, and they're not playing with the high-resolution textures or whatever, yeah, or if they're playing at a low resolution, then yeah, it's not going to look very good. I'll admit that. But, you know, if you're playing the game, I mean, it's an older game, so it does allow a good bit of forgiveness with, you know, what kind of computer specs you need, right, in order to be able to play with it. New areas look great. Models update is a good idea, though. That seems to be the general theme, and there's been some discussion around whether or not the devs, now that, of course, that it's Standing Stone, as to whether or not the devs will be, you know, revamping character models. But I have to believe that, you know, character model revamp probably requires a good bit of development time, and I don't know whether or not that would be a good focus on their priorities, unless, you know, maybe they feel that, you know, by refreshing the character models that it will infuse a refresh into the game that will help to, you know, to bring more folks in to want to play it. I mean, that's ultimately what they're going to be dealing with is, you know, what kind of changes do they make to the game? You know, what kind of updates do they add to the game to make it so that people want to play it? You know, I can't tell you how many people I hear, "Oh, that game is still going? Really? You know, I played that like 4 or 5 years ago. I didn't think it was still going." So there's a lot of folks. We are seeing a lot of folks come back to the game. Shadow falls beyond Lothlorien, against which we must be prepared. So, you know, I hear it a lot. I hear a lot of people say they're coming back to the game, you know. Let's see here. What do I want to choose? I'll take settings. Probably need to build up my settings and stuff. Okay. I guess I'm going back, right back where I came from. Guarantee a progression server would... Yeah, it would, but they've already said that they would never do that. The closest you're going to get to that is like what I'm doing over on Brandywine, which is to have a group of people that level cap their characters to go run the old content. Yeah, it probably would bring people back with a progression server, but yeah, that's just not going to happen. They've already said that. It just won't happen. Would like the character creation expanded, new hair. Yeah, new hair is not that hard. I have to imagine that, you know, they could probably do hairstyles pretty easy. But play on medium used to play on low and it still looked great. Okay. Model update is a good... I'm reading backwards, by the way. Model update, a good idea, but there's only a handful of games with better graphics overall. Yeah, unless you start looking at some of the newer engines, but the problem with the newer graphics engines, you know, first of all, they'd have to rewrite their code to take advantage of all of it. So even if you were to try using a new engine, you know, there's probably a whole ton of development effort that would need to go into something like that. And quite frankly, it's a question of, you know, whether it's worth it, development time-wise, right? You know, what does that get them? Does it get more butts in the seat playing the game? That's really what they have to look at, for, I guess. And you know, it's Standing Stone, so it's going to be a small development house. So you know, they probably have to use their time wisely, and of course they have updates to come out, so they have to schedule for that as well. So just make them on the same level as the Bjorning plus more choices. Okay. I play on a server that went up to Moria and stopped maybe just a little bit further. Yeah, but like I said again, they won't do that. They've already said that. Play on Brandywine and join Evil in the level 50 only content project. Yeah, that's like I said, that's going to be one of the ways that you're going to be able to do that, especially because those Angmar instances are not scaled. So if you want to play them on level, you know, we're doing that as a group thing on Brandywine. There are other groups that are doing it too. I'm not the only one. There's actually another group that I found out that's on Brandywine that's actually doing that. I was going to see about maybe seeing if we can get sort of a joint venture going there to get some more people to be able to do it. After that is when it started getting easy and there wasn't much effort put into the new content. I don't know about not effort put in. I think it's just the effort was focused on different ideas, different, you know, and you got to remember too, you have developers that come and go, you have, you know, whoever, you know, the game, the director comes and goes. You got to remember that Turbine was bought by Warner Brothers. So now you're you know, when that happens, you're answering to a different authority at that point in terms of what their focus is. And what we've seen now is that now that the game is no longer being developed by Turbine, is that you know, look at the direction that Turbine is going with their portfolio of games. They're going mobile, right? Which is not what this game is and never will be. So you had some people, I guess, in Turbine and Warner Brothers that were saying, do this, and, you know, the game is a product of that. And, you know, now it's Standing Stone, and it's a lot of the developers have been around the game for a long time, and I'm sure they have great ideas, and I'm really actually excited to see what the next progression of the game is going to be. I think it will be some good stuff, and we've talked about that a lot already in the past. you know, with the changeover to standing stone and that sort of thing. So I think it'll be interesting to see and to watch that that change and transition, to see what they have in store for us. So hey, you got bumped out, huh?
Oh man, the whole, it's funny, as soon as I went downstairs to grab the flashlight, as soon as I did that, the power came back.
Because that's always the way that it goes, right?
It's like it's like a little hobbit tricks.
Yeah, there you go, there you go.
Little hobbit was playing tricks on
me. Let's see, sadly, it wouldn't be the same experience. Leveling is so much faster now. Yeah, and we've already seen that. And that's if you choose to level too, and that's one of the other things that I actually found was nice about doing the level 50 hold was there's a lot of group content, there's a ton of content, even solo content in Angmar, and most people are like, gotta level, right? You know, you gotta get more levels, and you know, and even if you're not trying to level, you wind up leveling, right, Gus?
Oh my gosh, you know? There is more content in this game.
Yep.
I mean, you out-level the
areas. You'll out-level areas very, very quickly, yes. And we saw that.
Especially if you do the questing.
Yeah. And like, when I started working on my level 50 burglar and was basically re-leveling the game, right, from scratch, I mean, I started out trying to power level. I had no intention of stopping at 50. That really hadn't entered into my mind. And you know, I was always questing in areas that were 3 to 5 levels higher than I was at any one time. Because, you know, and I would level so fast. So there was so much content left for me to actually go back and redo, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because I had skipped so much because I was just like, oh, okay, I just want to be in areas where I'm going to get, you know, maximum benefit from the XP.
That's so. What happened with my hunter, with Nimwin. Like, mm-hmm. I'd say I did most of the storylines, like, to the point where sometimes everything would go out level, but I wanted to finish that, you know, like,
right.
I was like, for me, I was like, oh, I don't care if I had to get any XP or not. I just want to find out what happened.
Well, with, and you know, I think some of it,
family or this town.
Yeah. You know. Well, some of it, I think, has to be, there has to be a balance, I think, between, you know, getting enough XP to make leveling feel like it's important. Because obviously leveling your character is an important thing, right? Though we see changes with that, like in other games, and I won't mention anything specifically, but there are other games out there that you can play that really don't have any leveling. You advance your traits and character and skills and things as you go along through the game.
Yeah.
So there's other mechanisms for being able to advance in games. Leveling is just kind of the traditional one. You earn XP, you go to the next level, you get new skills, you get more, you know, you get more health and whatever. So it's a mechanic that's been around for a long time.
Yeah.
But the problem is that when you have scalable XP like what we have, you can go to an area and do the quests that are, you know, a few levels higher than where you are, and if you're successful in completing those quests and killing those mobs, then you level faster, right?
Yeah.
But what happens there is that I think the leveling progression has gotten skewed to the point where, yeah, you now you're leveling so quickly, and then of course if the XP is scaled, you level even that much more, you know, that much faster. You know, you look at a level 50 character, and my level 50 burglar has like maybe 3,000 health, right? At level 50. But yet you get to 105, and what do we have? 25, 30,000 health. Some characters with 50 or 70,000 health, depending on class, right? So it just seems like, you know, it became this progression where, you know, you get to here at 50, and then all of a sudden it's like the curve just takes off for, you know, your health You know, all of that. So, you know, I guess, I don't know if maybe that just got away from them, if it didn't scale well over time, you know, whatever the case may be.
Have come down from the mountains.
That is one place where that tortoise thing would come in handy, too, as
mm-hmm.
A shadow falls beyond Lothlorien. You don't necessarily want to... Must be prepared. Outlevel the area.
No, and the other side of that coin is if you, and this is in my experience, I've played a lot of characters in this game. I've restarted a lot of times. Okay, there's been times where I've gone back and played, you know, another character, you know, multiple times, and mostly that's because, you know, I wanted to start out playing them and, you know, level them for crafting purposes and stuff like that. So, and then I get bored and I go, oh, okay, well, let me go play this runekeeper over here, or let me go play, you know, my hunter, right? But the problem is then if you're running around in areas doing quests that you are above level on, now you're getting next to nothing in XP, and it almost seems like it's like trying to get through an area just for the sake of finishing everything. And being a bit of a completionist, because I know that there are a lot of folks that play this game that are completionists when it comes to that kind of stuff. That almost feels like the progress of your character then is too slow, right? Because now the XP gain is scaled in the opposite direction, so you get less XP for completing those green and light blue colored quests because you're too high for them, right? So now you feel like you're not making progress very quickly, and then you can easily become bored because you're like, oh my gosh, I haven't gotten a new level or a skill or anything in like forever, right? So that, you know, those are like, I guess, the two extremes in the whole thing. Yeah. Let's see. The trees made the old content super easy. Yes, they did, and I've already proven that in Angmar. Now, again, you know, using the Stone of the Tortoise and not leveling above 50 and doing the landscape stuff, you know, that helps. But we've done numerous forays into Urgarth and Carn Doom and Barad Guleron, and we've proven many times that you can go into Urgarth now with 3 level 50s, none of which is actually primarily a healer, and you can just tear the place up. That's just the way that it is, because we're just so overpowered at this point. So, not hard to level in this game. You can farm your farming and cooking from beginners to end. By the time you hit top tier farm and cook, you've hit level 49. Yeah, that's true. I was never a fan of granting XP for crafting. You know what I mean? We already had crafting XP, right? But I was never a big fan of them giving you actual experience points to level with by doing crafting. And again, I think that's just another example of something else that's just more XP gain that makes you out-level areas too quickly.
In my opinion, I think the reason they implement that is to... I think their reasoning behind it might have been to give people with multiple characters a way to level their alts without necessarily... Like, for example, if... Okay, say you have a hunter, for example, he's a woodworker, you know, forester.
Mm-hmm.
But you want an alt so that you can make your own food.
Right.
So you make an alt that's a gardener and a cook, and then I don't know what they were thinking, but my thoughts are...
What were they thinking? No.
We have a way to level the alts without necessarily having to go through and request everything.
And play the content.
Especially if it was just going to be for crafting purposes.
But then what do you... Then what, okay.
But you're right. Here's
my difficulty with that. Now you have a whole bunch of level 20, 30, 40 players that go, okay, now I'm going to go out and play this crafting alt that I've had, and I have no idea how to play it because all the skills have been added. I get this big button bar full of buttons in front of me. I have no idea what they do. Because I didn't level up with the character. You know what I mean?
I would say that then I would have to leave that on the player itself. Like, if the player, I don't want to say the word responsible, because I don't want it to make it sound like you must go out and do your stories and quests. Like, I don't want it to be that way, but if you don't take your character out and learn how to play,
mm-hmm.
then you kind of don't have anybody to blame but yourself for not knowing.
And therein, I guess, lies.
Of it is, you know, I've got characters that, you know, that I have solely for making food.
Oh sure, yeah, I have the same thing.
She's a level 34, and she's never stepped foot outside of Bree. You know, I wouldn't know the first thing about. She's a captain, I think. She wouldn't know the first thing about doing anything on that character.
Okay.
So I know for me personally, that character is absolutely nothing but cooking. She's never gonna leave Bree, and I'm never gonna take her out. Like, I just know that, like, okay, I don't have any interest at the moment in learning how to play this.
Right.
So I'm just gonna leave her there. Whereas I have other characters that, you know, if I'm on a whim and I want to be on a mini, I'll take a mini out. Or if I want to play my runekeeper, I'll take my runekeeper, my hunter or whatnot. Like, I just know, like I have it in my head personally, like, if she's a level 35, 40, 45, and she's never stepped foot outside the crafting hall, it would be easier for me to just start another character over.
Sure.
Relearn, and then to try and take it out. Now, not everybody's that way. Some people, you know, can take their alt out, and in 30 minutes, they have basic understanding of how to play their class.
Sure.
And then there's some people like me that's like, if I don't start it from the very beginning, I'll not know how to do it properly.
Well, I have some characters that are in classes, like this hunter included, where I haven't played them for so long that I honestly just don't have a good handle on the skills. I mean, basically, I wind up, maybe that's one of the intentions of hunters is, or you know, the classes in general is that, you know, like hunters, you could basically use a hunter on three simple skills that will just pew-pew everything, and it's kind of easy mode. And I beat up on hunters a lot because as a melee class, when I've got a hunter pulling all the stuff away from me, yeah, it's kind of a little annoying, you know, when you group with somebody that isn't sensitive to that, you know. It's like, well, if I'm in a group and I'm a burg, you better let me backstab stuff because that's what I do, right?
Mm-hmm. Well, you got to think about it too. When you are making your characters, when you're in the actual character creation page, it very specifically gives us, you know, this is a basic character, this is a medium character, this is an advanced, or class, excuse me, basic, medium, or advanced class. Like, when you're going through and you're sitting there and you're deciding, okay, what character do I want to be, you know, how much, you know, how difficult do I want to play, you know, mm-hmm. my character to be, and stuff. Like, I think that's why they give us the options of some classes are simple. And some classes take a lot of extra time and skill and effort. Sure. And I think that kind of gives us that option of, you know, how much, you know, do we, like you said, I mean, do we want to press three skills or do we want to have seven or eight skills?
Right, right.
Kind of, I guess it kind of just gives us that option of what do we want to do with this character.
Yeah, see, Coldfell, he's saying, Turbine said the reason for it when they implemented it was people were complaining that crafting yielded no rewards besides finishing. But the thing about that is
the whole point of crafting is,
well,
finishing.
Yeah, is that you have the ability to then craft. Well, because then you can craft the critted items. Mm-hmm. Now, they added guilds later on, right? Guilds were not something that were available from the very beginning. So crafting guilds themselves were added later as an additional incentive, you know, to continue to level crafting. You know, and gave you the ability, like, if you were, you know, if you were really well improved with your guild, you had, hang on, where's my, is that my removal? No. You had you know, you have the ability to craft critted items. Mm-hmm. You know, something that you only had like a maximum of a 70% chance to get. Because you'd have the best tools that you could have, and then you'd have to have the crafting journal, and then so that would give you maybe 60%, and then on top of that, then you'd have to have the 10% bonus scroll for crafting, right? So there were these things that you had to do for crafting, just to be able to get a critted item, which would give you like all of these pieces of gear that I'm wearing right now. Majestic March Warden's armor, right, is a critted armor piece that you had to get a single one-shot scroll, which was only, you know, you couldn't barter for them back then. The skirmish barterers didn't exist, right? So, I mean, granted, the game evolves over time, right? And they want to do things to make it more user-friendly and to make it more attractive for people to come play. I get that 100%. But there's a lot of things, I think, that became easier over time because it was probably easier to, I don't know, you kind of want to silence the naysayers, you know, so to speak.
Maybe silence naysayers, or maybe just the fact of, well, such and such game does this, you know, and everybody keeps telling us we should do it, so
right,
let's put it in there and see how, you know, let's see how it goes. Let's, you know, I mean, I don't know, I'm thinking maybe they just put, you know, maybe they implemented stuff because, you know, I'm sure a lot of it's probably community based driven, like, hey, we'd like to see this, or hey, we'd like to see.
Right. Black Misses, I do less DPS on my 88 Hunter than I did before the new specs.
Really?
That's interesting.
Do you
Hunter
have
used
all
to
your
be better.
Skills and your traits and your virtues and everything.
Yeah, that I would say, I don't know, if you have a fully traded, you know, class of any kind, I have to think that, you know, that you're hitting a lot harder now with the trait trees to like mobs than you were before. Now, granted, getting down into level 80s and stuff like that, you're down in other areas of the game. My experience generally thus far has been, you know, to redo the Angmar stuff has been holding at level 50, and in doing so, you know, only really working on Angmar instance content. So, which has not been scaled, right? None of that. They did revamp Angmar at one point, but they didn't scale it, right? So, you know, which is part of the reason why it was intriguing to be able to go back in and do that content on level, and which is why we're doing it. But playing the devil's advocate here, you also have to remember that if you're going to be the melee that essentially tanks, then you've got to be able to get that aggro back. I can pew pew all day on my hunter, but if my basic skills can overpower yours with no effort, then what am I supposed to do in the group? Trap and stun all day.
That's a good point.
It's a good point, but at the same time, in a group, yeah, your job is not necessarily to sit there and do all the damage. Your job is to trap and stun. You're a crowd control at that point, or you're a ranged tank if you're going to do that. Because there was a lot of that. Mm-hmm. I remember, you know, the Watcher raid in Moria was a really good example of a mechanic that was used to range tank, right? Because of the way that that the Watcher worked, you would have a hunter basically tanking from range because the mob can't reach, it can't come after you, and as long as you had, you know, good enough buffs and stuff on you for for avoiding the ranged damage, then you were okay with that. So that became the mechanic that a lot of teams used to go in and farm the Watcher once everybody figured it out.
Well, from a perspective of somebody who plays various MMO games or has played,
mm-hmm.
you know, there's one true rule that remains no matter what game you're playing, whether we like it or not. if you were in a group content, your tank is your tank and your healer is your healer, and you should never, ever pull the mobs off your tank. If even if you have more DPS and you're overpowered and it doesn't matter,
right,
you always slow down, cut back, you know, pull away, and you do the lighter damaging attacks, things of that. You never
and you start doing things to help the group
exactly
in other ways rather than just sitting there and unleashing pew pew damage, right?
And I think, unfortunately, that's the problem. And that's not just in this game. That's in all games.
Yeah.
Everybody has gotten into the tank and spank mode, the hurry up and blow the boss down mode, that nobody understands true group mechanics anymore.
Right. Well, and that was one of the other reasons why. And there's a lot of stuff going up in chat. And obviously, it's turning into a really great conversation. So I will address some more of it in a bit. And this is nothing to say that, you know, this is bad on the developers or I want to beat them up or anything. It's not that. We're just actually talking about the progression of the game over time, right? And games evolve and they change according to the player base and the needs of the many, so to speak, right? But, you know, the thing about, like, you mentioned the whole overpowering and tank and spank thing. One of the main reasons why I chose to do the level 50 content on level the way that we are, to kind of reminisce a bit and whatever and discover, you know, that content again. But it was also to sort of highlight how, you know, areas like that where it's not scalable, you now have a group of 105s coming in to just wipe out the content because A, they skipped it when they went through the first time around. And B, you know, they're just overpowered and basically they just tear through everything and destroy everything. And there's no mechanics involved other than, you know, just massive amounts of damage in a very short period of time. And they kill it. A good example is there was a run we did to do Barad Guluron one night. And you know where that is, right? BG up in Angmar. And it's a non-scalable level 50 instance, and at the end is Udunyan, is the boss mob in there. And I went in with a group, and it was like one of the first level 50, you know, groups we really ended up doing. And we went through the entire instance, and we got to the end, and there was one of the guys in the group said, "Okay, well, I know how to do this fight," and it was and nothing bad for them or whatever. It's just, you know, they were, you know, saying, okay, here's how we're gonna do it. So and they said, okay, well, what we do is we basically do a bunch of damage to Udunyan until he then starts to move, because he's rooted at the beginning of the fight until you get him to a certain point, and then we drag him out into the hallway and we just beat the snot out of him until he's dead. And if he goes to do one of his special moves, we just all get behind a pillar to avoid line of sight or something like that, and that's how you do it. So, like, okay, fine, let's give that a try, right? And, you know, that, obviously, back on level, we never did it that way, but we wound up doing that, and we wound up wiping because we weren't able to generate enough damage as level 50 characters, which is on level for that content, right? Mm-hmm. We couldn't generate enough damage to be able to beat him down like a 105 group can, right? So it forces you to go back to the mechanics that are required to actually do that fight, which is you have to fight him in the room, you got to have somebody tanking him in the middle, you got to have people standing on the stairways at the edges where the sigils are so that you can step in there and use the scroll and use the staff. And, you know, that's the way the fight was originally designed to be done. And with on-level characters, that's the way you have to complete the content. So something kind of gets lost with again, it's we leveled too fast to be able to do that content. And I think that probably happens in any game, and maybe you can highlight
it does.
That.
It happens
because
all the time.
You have level caps at certain points along the way in each game, because that's where the leveling stopped for a while until
right.
new content came out, right? So, you know, so it's like that. But
Blackness brought up a good point too. It's like people are too worried about leveling up nowadays. I've seen people with like no gear or the very minimum gear running around, and you mention it and they say, oh, I'll get it later on in the raids.
Uh-huh. Because they just want to get to 105, and then they because there's no point in stopping along the way, right? Mm-hmm. Which is one of the things that I tell everybody, and a lot of us tell.
It's just,
well, but this game again, this game and its story content is a lot more about the journey than it is about the destination, right? I tell people that all the time. This, you know, take your time in this game at least the first time through. Take your time, smell the roses. Enjoy the content. There's, you know, there's plenty of people to play with, you know, but I think some people are just like, they're like, I got to get to end game because that's where everybody is and that's where all the fun is. Yeah. Well, you know, it's not like that.
I'm the same. I would rather take my time and enjoy the stories and stuff, and I'll catch up with everybody when I catch up with everybody.
See, now Zeus says, I just arrived in Mirkwood and I already can't wait for a vacation. What is my favorite cook? What cook? What's, I don't know.
Coke?
Coke? I don't do Coke. I don't understand the question. Maybe it's a typo or something. So, Lego, throw that back up there again. I'm not sure what you're saying.
Cookie.
See, and even JM, my favorite cookie?
Yeah, what's your favorite cookie?
I probably would have to say, like, probably an Oreo. I don't know.
Really?
I like Oreos. Dip them in milk.
I do too.
You know, twist them open, lick the cream out, dip them in milk. I mean, yeah.
The double stuff. Absolutely.
See, now JM Wow says the worst thing I did on this game was level up the first tune too fast.
Yeah.
But he was good at the class, right? So, hey, Kryls, how are you, man? It's good to see you. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Bumble says, my gear is horrible for my 105. Did you level really fast? Let me ask you that. I'll just, you know, because that's what we're talking about, right?
Yeah, but his lore master looks fabulous.
But he looks fabulous. But you should see his wardrobe. Now,
he's got a really pretty robe.
Yeah. So all tune, I didn't do any crafting on it and regret that now. So all tunes after that have done crafting in some form.
Really?
Okay.
The dogs have awoken from their nap.
WoW has time walking dungeons that actually scales you down to its difficulty. Your gear does not matter. Well, you know, yeah, that's
just a minute.
I've seen that in other games too, where they'll scale you down as much as they'll scale you up, you know. At least in this game, you have inspiration buff if you're trying to do something that's meant for a group, right? Or, you know, so. But yeah, the one thing that LOTRO does not do is it does not downscale players to do older content. So it's really easy to get caught up in being, I'm 105, and you know, I go play everything, and you know, if I go join other groups, well, I'm doing it for them, so they're gonna do them at a lower level, so I'm just gonna go in and destroy everything for them. You know, twinking is what that's called, right?
Twinking, yeah.
Twinking.
Tennyson
yes.
says, so I've been playing LOTRO since it went live. I have a lifetime sub, and my highest character level is 40,
uh-huh.
And that's okay.
Yeah.
That's okay.
I have a lifetime sub, and my highest is a 105. But guess what? I only have one.
One of them, yeah.
Uh-huh.
I only have one 105.
That's all I've got. I mean, you know, but yeah, you haven't been playing it as long as me, though. I mean,
no.
I've been playing for 10 years, and I've got one 105 character. You know, you look at some other folks, especially some of the other streamers, there's guys that, you know, they're like, I have one of every class at 105. And they're all completely raid geared or, you know, whatever. You know, it's like, okay.
I'll be right back. I'm going to take the dogs out real
quick. Okay, okay. Although I do only play 1 or 2 days a month. And yeah, you know what? And again, that's the nice thing about this game too, is that it's here. You know, it's kind of, I don't know. It's a breath of fresh air kind of game, you know, because you can come in, you can play your character. That's the nice thing about, you know, whether you're free to play or you've got a lifetime or something in between, you know, you can come back and you know, just play whenever. So, the inspiration buff in is a lot of the older areas is crap. tricky at best to get it to work right. I don't know. I've never had that as an issue. Anytime I've gone to do something that had the inspiration buff, I've never really had any difficulties with it, so I can't really speak to that. I only play one hunter. I don't like alts. And that's cool. You know, some people are altaholics. I have alts for crafting, mostly. If you watch nearly every time I'm playing this game, you know, for me, I'm always on my Berg, right? One Berg or the other. Most recently, it was always the level 50 Berg because, you know, that was what I was working towards.
Orcs have come down from the mountains.
I have reputation now. What did I get? Friend of Lothlorien is next. Got squirreled there completely. Known to the Galadrim. Okay, so I have acquaintance standing, so that means I should be able to get in there now. Look. Legendary items need forging. Yes, we know that. You get bored with one class, so you switch a lot. Yeah, and again, you know, it's different for everybody, you know. Some people, like I said, I'm not necessarily an altaholic in terms of having to play all of my alts. I know a lot of folks that have a whole bunch of alts, and every time a festival comes through, they have to play every alt every day, so they get everything for every one of their alts, you know? But that's the thing about the game. It's like, it's, you know, play it the way that you want to play it, right?
You are welcome within Lothlorien.
You know, don't let, you know, what other people do dictate how you enjoy the game, right? All right, talk to Milwen. Where is Milwen? Now, this is book 7, which somebody was talking about getting in order to continue Lothlorien. The archway west of the hill of Cairn Amroth, located in the center of Lothlorien, far to the northeast of Talon Haldir. Okay. Alright, so we'll do that. We'll go that way. I don't have alts, I have many mains. Yeah, well, there's that. Depends on your definition of alts. Are you speaking of one main, several alts on one server, or alts on multiple servers? Yeah, I mean, you know, granted, I really only have ever played on two servers, and that's Landreval and now Brandywine. I was on Landreval for all those years. I never really had a lot of urgency to want to play anything on other servers. Now, as time has gone by, I've met folks, especially with the streaming community and whatever, I've met a lot of other folks from other servers, so, you know, now I'm like, oh, okay, well, maybe I'll go make an alt, something I would consider to be an alt, and I'll make that over on, you know, Evernight. I did that, actually. I made a tune over on Evernight so I could go do chicken play stuff with Stina and some of her group. So, you know, and that was fun, you know, so... Kryl says, I'm finally picking flowers. I'm glad I rushed in game. Yeah. I have some kind of crystal that adds 5, plus 5 hope, maybe plus 1 for buying some sort of version of the game. Yeah, you know, I have those too. Actually, I think I probably have... Well, I have the Horn of the Darrow Delph, which gives you a plus 1 hope for 15 minutes, right? I have it. It's not like I click it every 15 minutes because I feel the need to have to use it, but it's there. So am I able to get into Lothlorien now without dying? So here's all these other talons, right? I gotta find these. Talon Atharchen, Arken. Because that's a deed. So, before I go in here, oh, you know what? Totally, like, okay, I need to go this way. Chicken runs. Yeah, chicken runs are great. I love doing that. It's a lot of fun to play as a chicken. How often do you get to be a chicken in Middle Earth? I mean, come on, seriously. L Elder James started on Landreval back when the game came out. Yeah, well, yeah, and that's and I did too. And I my main kinship group was, you know, I ran a kinship on Landreval for a couple of years. I was sort of like a co-running it, but you know, I did a lot to help a kinship that that we kept running, and we were raiding three nights a week, and you know, that was back in the Rift and Moria days, right? And you know, so yeah, I was there. The Ithilien armor is so pretty. I really want to get there soon, at 105, and only at Pelargir. See, and that's the thing too. If you're at Pelargir and you are only 105, or you're already 105 at Pelargir, right? So Central Gondor. So you're here, and you're 105, right? So now you're going to head into Eastern Gondor. You've got all of this content up through here, up to Osgiliath, up to, you know, up to then from Osgiliath up to where am I looking for? Pelennor, right? You've got all this stuff in Pelennor with Minas Tirith. You got all that content. So and then you have all of the stuff for North Ithilien, March of the King. It's a ton of content, and yet you're already at 105, right? So, you know, that's kind of like what we were talking about before. It's just there's so much content. There's so many ways to get leveled in the game. You know, it's just it. That's it. The groups you'd get together for the hobbits to Isengard. Oh yeah. by the way, if for those of you who are in the chat that maybe haven't said hi or anything, hi everybody, welcome to the stream. If you are if you're not already following the official Lotro stream, make sure you give them a follow, because obviously that is good for the game and the stream and making sure that you know when official Lotro stream goes live. We've got a whole ton of great streamers that are on here every day of the week. Let me see if I can throw it up there. If you would like to see who the other streamers are, you can go to that stream team link, and that will show you who everybody is. If you like me and you want to go give me a follow, you can go to my stream as well and do that, which would be cool. What else? Let's see. Today's Thursday, right? So Thursday. See, I can't type today. So that's today's third day. See, I my typing is like really crappy today. I don't know why. There we go. So there's the Gussie was already on. I'm on now, and Technical 13 is up after me at 9 p.m. So, Eastern time. So you can check that out too. Yes, I'm plugging the channel. I gotta plug the Lotro stream while I'm here, right? No, they don't pay me. I'm not a paid spokesman. All right, so let's see here real quick. That is Skirmish Camp. I really don't need anything in Skirmish Camp here. Regret trying to use the Warsteed. Yeah, well, there is that. Wanderer of the Golden Wood. Yes. Oh, and there's even.
How can I be of service?
Oh, I need the. I need the Forge Master, because I have some things that need forging.
What can I do for you?
New stuff. All junk. Reforge. Legacy item I want to... A legacy I want to add to my Hunter's Spear. Stealth detection or desperate flight cooldown. Seriously? That's what you get for your offhand, right? Or at least your weapon and not your bow. I'll take the stealth detection, I guess. And crossbow. Add hunter damage over time or threat down. I think I'll take the dot for now. It wasn't too bad, as I'm even tough. The wolf was so stupid. Huh? Did I miss something? Regret doing Rohan so thoroughly. I was so overleveled going into Gondor. Wasn't too bad. Okay, I got you. Which flower should a blue line hunter be getting? Honestly, if you see a flower, pick it up.
Hail, stranger.
Hail, stranger.
I have a request of you.
Will you aid the Galathrim?
Will you help me?
And actually, you'll notice, you know what, I did forget to do this. You'll notice I'm actually level 60 right now, and I have the stone in my pocket. So I've stopped leveling, but because I'm now actually, well, because I don't want to be higher than level 60, because all of Lothlorien is still level 60 content, so I'm going to hold at 60 while I'm doing all of this before I get to Mirkwood. So, hunt protected deer in Lorien for deer meat. Yeah, see, there's not really anything that's a big advantage to doing that, so... The lag. Promptly start beating things with said flower. Okay.
What do you need?
Collect orc filth. Oh, I remember these quests. Yes, it's been a while since I've done these. So, actually, I appreciate all that discussion, honestly, because that's great. That's honestly what I like to see in the chat and stuff in these streams is, you know, some inspired discussion about the game and you know, everybody's experiences with it. It's always good to hear that, because, like, you know, if I just keep playing the game and be like, oh, I'm just playing it this way and it's just my way, it's, you know.
I'm back.
Hey, welcome back.
I was roughhousing with the dogs downstairs.
Okay. Did they beat you up a little too badly or what?
No, it's just running them around, burning some energy and stuff, so they'll chill for a
while. Yeah, you gotta burn them out after a while, yeah. Right?
Kind of like a 2-year-old. You gotta go find them something to play with for like an hour that's gonna absolutely exhaust them.
Right.
And then you're good for a few hours. So I think as a hunter, one of the new colors that I'm falling in love with for like my low level hunter is this walnut brown dye. It's so hunter, you know.
Uh-huh.
It looks really good on the armor. Oh, excuse me. Yeah. Just saying.
Don't forget there will be no technical 13 tonight or next week. He will return in February. Okay.
Oh.
Thanks for filling that in. I was not aware. I'm actually going to only run up until about 8 o'clock tonight. So, I'm not going to go the full 3 hours that I have done in the past. So, I'm only going to be here
really?
Until about 8. Yeah. So,
Oh, really?
Uh-huh. What are you trying to say?
Got somewhere you gotta be?
Uh-huh. You know where.
Oh,
oh, look at that. She's like, no, you're not. Yeah, I am.
I think we should have an evil stream for the next... What do you guys think?
For the next what?
For the next 4 hours.
Sorry, I'm not. That's not gonna happen.
That sounds like a big negative.
Ah, I'm stuck on a rock. All right. Where did I end up? Where the hell am I? All right. So here's which Talon is it? Okay. So here's another one. Talon Dolinhen. Yeah, gotta tag all the Talons for deed, right? All right, let's go back this way. Yeah, at least I didn't get shot to pieces while I was coming into Lothlorien, right? See, look, there's this orc corpse just hanging out here, and there's a bunch of elves right over there. You know, you'd think they'd come over and clean up the body, but no. Gussie's wise sage advice on how to care for grandkids.
That's right, Colesville. I'm telling you, my parents did it right. We lived on a farm, and it was like, all right, you kids go out and play, like right after breakfast or lunch or whatever. Go outside and play, and don't come back in until dinner time.
Yep.
And we ran ourselves. We ran ourselves ragged. First times were different and things were different.
Oh, you mean your parents, your parents and grandparents didn't treat you like a delicate little flower? And...
No, I'm hardly a flower.
Gussie, the delicate flower.
My parents were not helicopter parents.
Yeah, I did not have those either.
We had stuff to do on the farm. Like, you know, we had to feed our chickens and rabbits and goats and, you know.
Lions and tigers and bears.
In the summer and the fall and, you know, all that kind of stuff. Like, we had things that we had to do. Of course, we had a huge garden that we grew every spring and summer. And,
okay.
You know, we always had things to do.
Right. Well, but there usually is a lot of things to do on a farm, right?
Technology. We didn't have phones and Nintendos. And
no Atari 2600?
I think it was greetings. 10 if you had or so a moment. When the 2600 came out. We did get one.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, it was, I mean, I think I was like 10 or 11 or something when we got it. Somewhere in that range. Actually, we had a Pong first, so.
Coldfell says, is there a very important symposium on the subtle intricacies of Jar Jar Binks?
What?
And you have to be there? I think he's referring to me not being here, past 8 tonight.
What brings you to look?
I wouldn't necessarily call it a Jar Jar Binks symposium. But yes, it may happen in another universe. Oh, carry the arrows. Oh, God, I remember this one. You had to do this every day for reputation. I have to, like, carry the arrows all the way up to the, all the way up to the top camp. A phone is technology. They have been around a long time.
Yeah, but, Krauss, what I mean is we didn't carry them around in our pockets and have them glued, you know, tied around our necks and stuff like that. Like, we had to use our imaginations. We had to be creative. We had to make mud pies and build forts and tree houses.
And fall out of trees and,
you know.
Yeah.
One of my favorite things to do when I was a kid, where our road was, our driveway was 3/4 of a mile long, and it was a gravel driveway.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a bank on one side of it.
And you robbed it?
No.
You burgled it?
We used to take old boxes and break them down, and we slid down the hill on the boxes.
Mm-hmm.
Dirt slides.
Well, it's interesting, you know, when you don't have something like video games in front of you, how creative you could become.
Oh, yeah.
With the other things that are around you.
Yeah. And I only drink had my RC brother cola. And my sister. Our nearest neighbor was a mile and a half away, so it's like, me and my brother and sister, we had each other. That's what we did, so.
Drink RC cola and eat moon pies.
Ooh.
Yeah.
I used to like RC cola when I was younger.
Till I was 16, I carried a dime and later a quarter in case I had to make a call from a payphone.
Phone call, payphone, exactly.
Yeah, God forbid you actually made... Oops, one of my lights just kind of dropped. Ah, let me fix that.
I heard that.
Did you heard it?
Yeah, I heard something go poom.
Uh-huh, that was one of my lights. Low tech here. I have low tech lighting. Oh, and of course I'm still running with arrows in my hand. I'm running with arrows. Stop running with arrows. You'll poke your eye out.
Yeah, Coltsville. My mom had a little leather coin holder that she gave each of us kids, and she'd put a little bit of change in each one of them, and then put them in our little. We didn't even have backpacks. We had like just these
fanny packs.
No, it was I don't want to say it was like a shopping bag type of thing, but it was just like this big handled bag.
Like a canvas bag kind of thing?
Kind of. We'd put all of our school books and our peaches. Of course,
kind of like the reusable shopping bags.
Except for it only had one handle instead of two, so it was kind of like a purse strap kind of thing.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what we had. She had these little leather coin things that she made for each of us, and she put a couple of quarters and a couple of dimes in it, and we kept it in our bag, and that was our emergency money if, you know, we missed the school bus or something and we had to call home. Life was so different back then.
J.M. Wiles is from the South and sounds like an Alabama boy. RC and moon pies, where the moon pie has been microwaved, or RC cola and honey bun. Oh, I like honey buns. Oh, I love honey buns.
Yeah, my hubby did too.
Did?
Yeah, we don't get them around here much, so I don't get to...
Okay.
Welcome to the Golden Wood.
Get to see them around here too much. Occasionally, I think they have like boxes of them at Walmart, but I don't shop at Walmart too much.
Well, we have. Do you have Tasty Cakes where you live?
I don't think so. It doesn't sound familiar.
It's very much an East Coast brand.
I think we have Little Debbie stuff. And
But like we get, the honey cakes with, you know, they're just so good. From Tasty Cake.
When I was in the Marine Corps, I was, when I was going to school, I was back at Lejeune. So we used to get the honey buns and stuff all the time back there. But I don't see them very much out here.
XOS, hey, how are you, man? What is the class where your hands are glowing green? That would be a minstrel.
Mini.
Yeah, that's a minstrel. That's a healing class. What?
Is the glowing hands for healing or for DPS?
I forget which stance that is.
Hmm.
I don't remember.
I think when I was on my mini the other day, my hands were glowing. And I think
I think that's for DPS.
Yeah,
honestly.
DPS. Yeah, I think her little character is in red line at the moment. I'm gonna get some of this walnut dye. I'm really liking this color for my low level skirmish hunter armor. I've accomplished absolutely nothing since I've been in here with you, except buy some dyes. Oh, I did go to the skirmish camp and update my armor thing. Because Bumble says my armor was hideous. And if we're going to be going into, you know, leaving Tom Bombadil's and going into the Barrows and heading to Bree, I've got to...
Right.
I need to look good doing it.
The minstrel is for healing. The minstrel's original... I mean, they are the original healing class for this game when it was released. Now, of course, since then, you know, we obviously have several other classes that can heal. But minstrels are still great for heals, but they also do a crap ton of damage, too. Depends on how you're traded, like every other class.
Ooh, I wonder how this dress would look with the brown. Ooh, that's pretty.
Drink
like
your Coca-Cola after you put in the peanuts? I don't understand that reference.
Bumble.
Yeah, Bumble's gonna come judge your latest attempt at fashionery.
I will say, though, that the festive azure party dress does look extremely good in a walnut brown tone. It almost looks like chocolate.
Right. You can be a minstrel. If I understand your question, which is what races are they for, then you can be a minstrel in any race with the exception of Bjorning.
Nope, that's class you mean.
Bjorning is a race.
Oh.
In addition to being a class, but it is...
Oh, okay, okay.
Yeah, yeah, so...
Wait, men can't be minis, can they?
Absolutely.
Oh, I didn't realize that.
Yep.
I thought it was... like elves, hobbits.
Nope. My minstrel, which is like level 95 or so, is mm-hmm. is human. So the race of men. We're men.
Men
in tights. Remember that movie?
What brings yeah. you to Lothlorien?
I need to see that again. It's been way too long.
It's been a long time since I've watched that, yeah. Speak with me. All right, so these are all just repeatables.
Welcome to the Golden Wood. May we speak?
And that will get me reputation with the Galadrim, but you don't need all that much reputation with the Galadrim in order to... Because it used to be that when you would come through here back when this was level cap, you had to have a whole mess of reputation in order to get into the Golden Wood, right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. So, and you would run around doing the dailies until you got enough reputation for that. And then you'd have to do, there were these dailies, and then there were more dailies that you would do around Karas Galadon and Karan Amroth. You would do stuff around there to get you more reputation daily so that you could then actually get into Karas Galadon. And then once you got in there, then there was a whole crap ton more stuff you could do. Never understood why I never understood why elves couldn't be captains either. If there was going to be another race that could be a captain, I would think that it would be the elves. Mostly because they're just tall and nobody's going to listen to you as a captain if you're a dwarf or a hobbit. You know, it's a... Napoleonic syndrome kind of thing, I think. Men in Tights was Dave Chappelle's first movie, I believe. Oh, really? I didn't know that. Trivia for the day.
Damn. Digging that walnut brown. That looks pretty good. Especially on the low-level leather, it looks really...
So, if I were to make a mini, I should be a hobbit? The nice thing about being a hobbit is that you do get a racial skill called Hobbit Silence, which does tend to be helpful as a minstrel because you can drop aggro that way by just feigning death. Mm-hmm. And basically, you're playing dead and... That can be a good thing as a minstrel. I made you sing it in your head, the Men in Tights song. That seems kind of appropriate considering I'm now traveling through the Golden Wood, right?
Mm-hmm. Well, what was Haldir? I mean, he wasn't a captain, obviously, but what was he was...
Haldir?
Haldir, sorry.
I don't know.
What was he considered? I mean, I know he was, like, a leader, and he was, you know... Like, what was he considered in terms of a... class?
I don't know.
I mean, obviously, he had the bow skills of, you know, ungodly He was incredible. A warden. That's what I was trying to think of. He's a
Haldir
warden.
Was a warden.
Warden.
Now, you'll notice, like, when you go and launch the game and you go play a character for the first time, mm-hmm. you ever see how it says that this particular class was inspired by so-and-so from the actual books, right? So there's some of that around, too. Or you can, you know, if you want to... Because, obviously, you know, being a guardian is inspired by Samwise. You know, so... And you wouldn't think that. You'd be like, oh, you know, it's got to be something tough, like a dwarf, you know? But you know... Yeah, Samwise is the inspiration for the Guardian class. So I'd be curious to see if that actually holds true for the Warden. You know, if like Haldir is the inspiration for that.
So I'm wondering if like, just say for example, I mean, Boromir, would he have been?
Few only have had the joy of
champion
or place.
Yeah, I guess he kind of would have been like a champ.
Well, the champion class was actually inspired, I think, by one of the dwarves.
A moment, friend, before you go.
Luthien was the inspiration for Minnie.
Oh, really? Okay. See, probably more things for you to study or read up on when you do your
when
book reading stuff. Yeah.
Celebrimbor was the runekeeper. Well, I knew Elrond was the lore master. I remember that one.
Elrond for the lore master? Really?
Yeah, I remember seeing that. I remember reading that.
Interesting.
Hail,
but
stranger.
It does make me think, like, rested, about the other characters in Middle-earth, like...
The Galadhrim will need your
aid. What would they have been considered, you know...
Right.
If they were an in-game, like...
I found Frodo! Yay! I haven't seen Frodo in so long.
So what's up, Frodo?
So yeah, what up? What up, dude?
How's it going? How's that ring treating you?
Yeah, well, not very good because I got a bunch of dread by standing next to him right now.
The Warden was inspired by... Okay.
Warden was inspired by the March Warden of Lothlorien, Haldir. There you go. Gussie, where are you hiding? You may be a judgy moose, but immature judge you this time.
I'm up at the task board. I was going to turn in some tasks.
All right.
We have come such a long way, haven't we?
Hello there.
I could make some...
I love what Mary says. Hello there.
Mary is one smart dude. I tell you what. If I ever go traipsing across Middle Earth, I totally want Mary.
Oh, that was Sam.
Mr. Merry is out taking
no,
a walk.
No, Mary's smart. I know he'll be
Yeah.
I want Mary. I'm assuming that.
I thought Mary was a fool
it
of a took.
In its pockets, does.
Isn't he the fool of a took? No, because he's
Pippin
a brandy buck, right? So who's the took?
Pippin is a fool
Pippin.
Of a took.
Pippin is the fool of the took. Yes.
I'm assuming short fuse is you, Bumble, so I'm assuming I have your... Somebody was just checking me out.
Oh, my.
Yeah, Cold Still, it was one of the things that when we were talking about in the book, the book discussion yesterday, one of the things that I did not know, which was one of many, obviously. But the
something
one thing
that
Gussie really,
didn't know. No.
I know. Like, that doesn't happen 10 times a day. But one of the things that did blow my mind was the fact that he was very knowledgeable about, you know, the comings and goings of the Shire. He knew about the ring. He knew, he'd read Bilbo's book. And he was, it's funny. I was saying it today. I was like, Merry is the kind of guy who, like, he knows things. He doesn't want people to know that he knows things, but he knows things.
Merry Brandybuck, right? I drink and I know things. Oh, and he's short like a dwarf. Wrong universe, right? You've seen those t-shirts, right?
Yes.
For Tyrion Lannister. I drink and I know and things. I need to buy one of those. I need to get one of those or something like that and have that shirt. I drink and I know things.
Bumble, no, that was a creeper. I haven't found you. Somebody was checking me out.
Oh my.
Checking her out. Use that. That's level 30.
Alright, let's see. I need to collect red berries. Or talk to Mary.
Oh. Brokenwood spirit? Brokenwooden. God, I can't turn any of this. Oh, here we go. Skins. I've got all these level 30 items to turn in for rep. Oh. Found Bumble.
The Bumble? Mm-hmm. Found the Bumble.
That's not a bad attempt. You'll give me that much. Thank you. I mean, I have had limited resources to work with, so I did the best that I could. You want to join a fellowship? All I'm going to do is turn some stuff in over here at the... I'm just going to go turn some rep in. See if I can get to level 30. Whoa, what the heck? There we go. Did you get real quiet on me, or
me? I'm here. I'm sorry. I was looking at a couple of stream things. So, I'm picking up berry bushes. So, yes. I'm busy.
In the berries.
I'm busy. I gotta collect berries.
Macers.
So close to finishing expert scholar, yet so far away. Yeah, there's usually that. Scholar has got to be probably the toughest one to do. There's definitely no doubt about that. Mary berry bushes? What? You mean many? I don't know. No, there's something about
many
that.
Many berry bushes.
No, you said Mary berry bushes. I don't get the reference unless it's a typo. What is the respawn rate for warbands? Don't know.
Huh. Isn't it like a couple of times?
Some of them are different. You can kill one and like certain ones and they'll come back like 2 minutes later.
Hmm.
But you can only do a warband quest once a day.
May the stars of Elbereth shine upon you.
Yeah, you can do the warband and you can get the gift.
May we speak?
You can kill them more than once, but you won't get any goodies after the second, or after the first time.
Because it's all about the goodies.
That's right.
Cassandra, I don't understand what you're saying there. Sorry.
I think they speak. I remember Cassandra from before.
If it's a language thing, yeah. Honestly,
yeah.
English,
Cassandra,
please.
We gotta speak in English. I'm
sorry.
Yeah,
it's an English chat. Sorry. This is a Wildmoor survival quest for Shaguk, but he is nowhere. Usually it doesn't take them terribly long to respawn.
Somebody might have just gotten
Yeah.
To pop up again.
Oh, Wildermore. Yeah, Wildermore is fun. I like that area, actually. My champion and my minstrel are still up in that area. But I haven't played them for forever. I'll help you with that. Oh, well, I got this. Okay.
Are you gonna translate?
Is that what you're doing? Maybe Kryls is gonna translate. Although I see a whole bunch of numbers and stuff. I don't know what that is. Yeah. It's looking a little odd.
Oh. Goober.
Don't do that. Just,
gotta be careful, because the bot in the Lotro stream channel is really...
Yeah,
crazy.
If it starts to see that as being, like, spam or something like that, you will get timed out. The bot
she
is,
might time you out for it, yeah.
Yeah, the bot is a bit sensitive. Alright, let's see. I gotta go turn that in. I need the saplings, which I think are way over here. Yep. Oh my gosh, I so remember doing these every day to get reputation over here. Ugh. Do you need it anymore? Do you have to do these for reputation to get into Central Lothlorien
now?
Yes,
you have
yeah.
to do everything.
You still have to do them?
We have to. Not as we're just Tom saving the hobbits, but... Bumble, you have to work through these issues with your
Yeah, hobbits. let's be a little considerate of our fellow Chad members, please.
Come on, Bumble.
We are an international.
He's talking about hobbits and Tom Bombadil.
Oh, I thought they were talking about something different.
He doesn't care for Tom Bombadil. He doesn't like his music.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he doesn't like his singing.
Just to show you how much I've been playing something else, I keep pushing the shift button to make myself run faster. Lothlorien restriction got lifted back at 95 endgame. Oh, really? So you can just get in now? So I don't have to do all this crap anymore?
Don't tell him that.
Oh, thanks, Gussie. You knew?
No. Oh.
You're so bad. I would have been running around out here for weeks as this hunter trying to get myself into Lothlorien. Why are you doing that, man? You don't have to do that anymore.
Way to go, guys.
Yeah, there you go. Thanks, Gussie. That'll be a new meme. Thanks, Gussie.
Hey, no problem. That's a pretty bird. Oh, shit. It's about dinner time. Let's see.
Evil, you should know this by now. Gussie's evil? Really? Apparently, yes.
Oh, shit. Sorry.
Hey, now.
Sorry. Yes.
All right, let's see. Let me get the last of these. The last of these trees. I seem to remember there was something about killing the shrews out here, too. All right, well, I think I'm going to head back over here. and I think we'll be done. Let's see. I'm surprised. Wow, this 2 hours went like super fast. All that discussion
we still
had.
Have one more hour to go.
I gotta stop early.
But next week, Technical is not going to be here, so that means you get to stream for 7 hours.
No.
Or next Thursday.
I honestly can't do that late at night because I need to get up for work in the morning, and I, you know, staying that late on a weeknight is just not viable, or at least I don't know, not that long anyway. 7 hours. It's not like he goes for 4 hours, does he? I don't know.
I don't know.
How long does this stream usually run?
I have no idea. Because by that time, usually I've got to start getting, like, after about his second hour is when I usually have to start, like, getting stuff.
That's when
ready
you usually start nodding off.
And, no, that's when I start, like, getting stuff ready for, you know, laundry done. And,
right.
Whatever I'm going to make for Bill's lunch tomorrow, I get out of the, you know, get out and start preparing. And stuff.
How much did Shoemaker pay you to sit here and chat and remind us? Oh, that's probably one of his bots. Either that or he's there doing it himself. That's not, it's not me.
It's.
It's not me. I didn't do it. Anyway, where's the hill? Where's the hill I'm looking for? There it is.
Is it way over there? Oh, he's on for 4 hours, Julie Strider? Yeah.
I didn't know.
Yay, I found Mary.
I can tell you that.
Yay. Is he quite contrary?
I actually had a pet hamster when I was a child named Pippin.
Really?
I did, yes.
Aww.
My sister convinced me to name it Pippin because she was reading the books at the time. She said you should call him Pippin. So there you go. Hey, Rifterdell, how are you? All right. I think this is a good place for me to stop, though. I'll have to pick this up again, I guess, maybe next week. But, wow, there's 50 people in here. I almost feel bad about leaving.
You should.
There's a lot of folks in here. But I need
to... You're doing
a
good show.
What's that?
Because you're doing a good show.
I am. And it honestly, it's been great tonight. There was a lot of really good discussion about the game in general and its progression and whatever. You know, that's always good stuff. I love having, like, some nice debate about things like that and talking about it, so... So that was all good.
Hey, Rifterdell.
What's that?
Rifterdell was saying hi.
Yes, because I said hi, Rifterdell, because he said hi, Evil and Moose. you would have guessed she. Oh, what's that? You have. I missed something. She was a fan of the Broadway play. With Pippin, I guess, or something, or I don't know. I don't get the reference. Sorry. okay, let me see here. I gotta transition in my other scene here. Look, now you get large version of me. Hi. Green screens are fun. I'm enjoying this whole thing that like makes the streams look better and whatnot, so it's been fun. But that's probably going to do it for me for tonight, everybody. So, thank you very much for coming out. Like I said, it was a great stream.
Is anybody else streaming?
I don't know. Is there somebody else that's streaming that we can throw everybody at and go raid?
Let's go see really quick.
Games. Lotro. Mort's on.
Oh, Mort.
Yeah.
Well, there you go.
Yeah, why don't we go do a raid on Mort?
Mort some love.
Yeah. So why don't we do that? Let's go do a raid on Mort, because I know everybody will love hanging out with Mort for now.
Bearded
Mort. I now of Mortumbra? What? Tally, that's like the first thing I've seen you say all night, man. Where you been? Unless he's like been hanging out in my Discord and I like wasn't letting him speak or something. No, he's not there either.
Maybe he just got home.
All right. There is the link. Thank you very much. Yeah, so So we're going to go do a raid on Mort. As for me, you can all check out my... I also do a Lotro stream on Sunday mornings, usually starting between 8 and 9 a.m. Eastern. I call it my Sunday morning Lotro coffee stream. So you can come check me out there, and we can do some more discussions about various things Lotro-wise there. So so come check that out. You can also follow my stream at that link. You can check out Gussie Moose at hers, too. What else we got? We got Thursday, right? So there's all of us for today. So there you go. Thanks everybody again for a great night. We're going to go do a big raid on Mort. So everybody head over there and give them lots of Lotro raid love. And I'll see you all again real soon. Thanks again. Have a great night.
Night, you guys. Meet you guys over at Mort's. Gosh.
I think we are officially hosting now.
Boy, that beard of his is getting big. Are you gonna? Do you want me to drop the raid in there, or did you do it?
Okay. I just did the. Okay. I just did the host.
Oh, look at that! Being hosted by the official stream. 70 viewers.
70 viewers? Wait, he said 70 came in?
Yeah, it's not letting me. There wow. We go. Good, there it goes. Cold stuff. Good deal.
You're being hosted by the official stream.
Nice.
Apparently.
Oh, I should host him too. Hold on.
Nice. Lotro raid, and apparently, for some reason, there's a big old host train going on, but...
And now there's a host train going on, too. His numbers are going to, like, skyrocket.
That's good.
That's
he
awesome.
He deserves it. Host.
And now he's going to get a bunch of follows, too, from people that don't usually watch his stream. So that's great. I'm glad I could do that for him. Yeah, that's good.
Good evening.
Oops. Oh, no. UMBRA. Are you off?
Actually, I didn't shut down my stream yet.
What's up, Gussie? What's up, Meg? Cold Bells?
Probably would be a good idea to do that.
Strider? Kryls?